Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Hey, what's going on, guys? This is X25, and welcome back to some more Beamng Drive. Yes, I am back once again, and today we are actually going over a vehicle mod. It's the Ibishu Kashira, because I noticed that this thing has been updated a lot, and I figured that it was worth reviewing. So if you are enjoying Beamng on the channel, and if you do want to see more, hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. Anyways, yes, there are actually three variants if you go into the vehicle selector here. As you can see, there's the Kashira US version, JDM, and the EU. Right now, we have the US version. This is the default variant. And yeah, it looks pretty nice. It's your typical minivan. That is a weird place for the shifter. That's a weird place for the shifter. Why is the dash a little bit low poly too? And where's the radio? Oh, I guess it's right there. Huh. Yeah, this has a weird setup. Yeah, but one cool thing about this van is that, hold on, if we open up here. Wait, this thing has a stop. Okay, a stop sign, really? Oh, right. What is this? Okay, for some reason I have different controls. Okay, anyways, yeah. Left sliding. There are sliding doors. Look at that. I'm actually surprised that there are no minivans in Beamng already. But yeah, let's actually drive this around, shall we? But I'm actually going to change the camera angle for this just so that I can see a bit better. Oh, it's been so long since I actually played Beamng. Well, I actually did play it a little bit for a bit when multiplayer came out. And it was pretty fun. It was fun while it lasted. But right now I'm working on rolling lines and trying to finish up those areas of the map that I moved on from. Just so that way we can go on, continue to work on different areas of the map. Because I feel like that you guys have gotten bored with doing, seeing like the, like episodes with the in the same area of the map. But anyways, yes, enough of rolling lines. We just crashed it. That's actually, it actually didn't do much because the van's still able to drive just perfectly fine. Yeah, this reminds me of like an episode of Top Gear where like they took that Toyota truck and then they put it through all these extreme tests and they beat the heck out of it, and somehow it was still running after they flooded it, they crashed it, they even burned it, like it was still somehow running. But yeah, anyways, there we go. I can guarantee you that this thing is not going to be running after this. Oh, yeah, you're probably not surviving that way. Do the doors still work? It tells me they still do. Oh, nope, they broke. Okay, that I just saw a glitch part. Good thing we reset it there. Okay, so yeah, that was the base version. It had all-wheel, it was the 2.5T LX all-wheel drive variant. There is actually a beta version, and then there's the gruesome, which looks really interesting. It does have some damage on it. Does it actually come with that? Oh, it does. That's actually kind of cool. Okay, that's all. Okay, just have to make sure it drove, because it didn't really look like it was able to drive. It was going to drive for a minute. Okay, yeah, I just wanted to find that out. But yeah, my curiosity has now been fulfilled. And then you have a cargo version, which I actually kind of like this. It's like a panel van, which you don't really see. This type of van in the US. I don't know why this is in the US variant, because you don't really see these types of vans here. Like, you do have a typical panel van, but you don't really have a minivan panel van, if that makes sense. Like, there used to be like postal vans that were basically this variant, but they still have the windows, and yeah, you don't really see them that often. Usually you would see like something like the H series in America. Because, yeah, you don't really see these too often. Like, you might on a very rare occasion. Although, I don't really know. You don't really see these too often. You would see more of a beefy van. But, yeah, I just thought this would be cool. But, yeah, the only variants I would think that would have this would be, like, a postal van. But even then, like, the Like, the postal vans I remember seeing, like, the last postal van I remember seeing had windows in the back and not like that. So, yeah. Anyways, moving on from the panel van, it's just basically a base model except with panels on it, and like the rear seats are stripped down and everything. It has a turbo, there's a turbo burger livery, there's a crash test variant. There's all that. There's a taxi, which looks like it has something on the top of it. It might have an advertisement, which is always cool. Let's see. Oh yeah, look at that. That looks cool. Now this I've actually seen a couple times. This is like for like people with wheelchairs. That this is usually what these taxis are used for. Especially at my job. Like I have seen a couple of these every now and then. And like it looks cool. It does look cool. I do admire the look of these things. They look really sleek. I like the color, and I also like them in yellow. It's not because yellow is my favorite color. That's not why at all. I just like the look of a yellow taxi. I don't know. But yeah, let's just pretend that we're a crazy taxi driver. Not as in like the video, like the actual video game. Oh yeah, like that. Oh wow, those pieces went flying. Yeah, we have impaled ourselves in a tree. All right, let's actually do something else with the US variant. Let's see. We do have a police livery, which I don't really know what you would use this for. You have a raised version. Let's see. A police and a marked police variant. That's kind of cool. A low rider. Oh, wait, there's a low rider for this? Why? There's a show car, there's a special pursuit unit for this. And there's a tuned version, there's a mobile custom. A sleeper, which is probably fast, a drift, a muscle van. I wonder what that is. A custom, an R custom. Wait, 2042. What is that supposed to mean? Okay. Cash EVA, what is that? Let's see. Wait, is that supposed to be an Evo or something? Like, okay, there's a rally, there's a not a rally, there's a drag version, there's a Jado hill climb, there's a bunch of ridiculous ones, but we're gonna just for the sake of this video, we're gonna choose the low rider because I just want to see how this thing balances. That's my only interest in this vehicle. Wait, what is in the Oh, what? Oh, wow, that's a cool hydraulic setup. Look at that. You can see all the wires and all the hydraulic systems. That's kind of cool, actually. Okay, let's try this. Raise all. And then you can go back down. We can hop. Okay. Hold on a minute. Whoops. Why can't I? Okay, for some reason it doesn't actually work. That's kind of disappointing. Hold on a minute. Hop all. Does that work? Oh, that works okay. Hold on a minute. This could get entertaining. It's like it's happy or something. It's like Herbie. Herbie the Love Van. Oh my gosh, I just found it. Wait a minute, hold on. I must do something real quick. All right, hold on. What just happened? Give me a minute. Hello everyone, this is Herbie, Herbie the Love Van. Herbie likes to go fast and jump. As you can see right now, he is happy and wants to be your friend. Herbie also likes to do dirt racing and do various stunts, like his famous jumping over the ditch technique. Herbie is dead. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Hold on. Okay. I'm sorry. I just had to do that. That was hilarious. All right. Anyways, back to the video. This is actually the Wobble Custom, and what this thing basically is that's an off-road version. So just think of it as a A van that's been turned into like a crossover, like the characteristics of an SUV or a crossover. Because yeah, it also has like a tow hitch, and I actually might try and tow a caravan with this thing. Actually, I probably will. Wait a minute, wait a minute. But I want to take this thing on a dirt road. That's like the main reason why I brought this thing out. Let's see how well it does on like a dirt on a, like a dirt road. Let's see here. Oh wow, that didn't last long, did it? Hold on a minute. I would like to find a dirt road, please. I think I wait a minute. I just saw one. There's one between those trees, I think. I'm just going to drive slow, and I'm not going to stop until I find a dirt road. But yeah, it does handle quite well on the road. Well, obviously, because like it's a van, it's made to go on roads like these. Here we go. Here's a dirt road we can go on. Oh yeah, here we go. Now we can mosey along. Yeah, look at this. This is actually kind of relaxing. Yeah, I feel like this is like the van where you would take all your family on a like a giant road trip, and like you go up north and you go camping or something like that. I feel like this is the like the van you would use for that type of thing. Because you know, why not? But yeah, as you can see, it does do off-roading quite well. Oh, and again, that is kind of what it's made for. Hold on, I know there's another dirt road down here. There it is. All right, let's go down. This thing would be perfect for Utah, like the Utah map. I don't know why, but I just feel like it would. Yeah, look at that. Check this out. Yeah, this is nice. It even has like differential locks and all that. All right, now time to actually try and crash this thing. Which should be easy to do because I feel like this thing's top heavy. Or we could just do that. That works too. All right. So the only thing left to do with this thing is to attach a caravan to it, which I'm going to do right now, and I'm going to do the standard one. Oh, okay. It's already set to the standard. Let's spawn this. I hope this works the way I want it. No, the parking brake's on and it's rolling down. Whoa, whoops. I accidentally put up the coding. Hold on. Okay, that just happened. Okay, maybe I shouldn't have parked it, like put it on like a hill. All right, let's just slowly back this up. L. Hey, there we go. Whoa. I forgot how unstable these things can be. Well, let's go into the interior. Oh wait, do I dare and try the cinematic camera? I do dare to try to send that camera. This is actually going quite well. How have I not crashed yet? Whoa. Okay, I might have spoke too soon. There goes the camper. I'm somehow okay. How is that thing not destroyed? Oh wow, it's actually sagging the van down. I just now noticed that. Oh wow, that thing's got some speed behind it though. Holy cow. Oh, okay, there we go. There's the crash I was waiting for. Wait a minute. Hold on it. How is the Hold on a minute. How is the camper alive? Wait, look at the van and look at the camper barely has its How? Oh, the interior is a different story, but that's you can't even tell. Hold on a minute. Let's give this thing the proper justice it deserves. Hold on. I want to blow this thing up. Alrighty, let's just teleport the van up here. And we should come crashing down in 3, 2, 1. Boom! There we go. There's the satisfying destruction we need. Alright. Oh, oops, I accidentally reset. Wait, what? You can reset the camper van with the car? I didn't know that. Hold on. Detach. Detach. Thank you. Wait, I don't think it detached. Oh no. No, detach. Thank you. Ow. Okay. Next vehicle. I've already wasted too much time with the camper van. All right, so let's try we're gonna try at least one custom variant because I feel like that would be the proper thing to do. Probably not any of these. What is this? Instead of scrapping the car when the engine died, the owner of this one converted into an E. Oh, it's an electric vehicle. Okay, hold on. This caught my interest. Oh my gosh, yes. Oh, let's get onto the road so that way we can actually test it. Oh, come on. You can get up there. Come on, with all that torque, you can get up there. I just see the camper just laying there. Come on, come on, come on, come on. You are a disappointment. I'll just do it myself. There we go. Let's try this now. See, that's better. Oh my gosh, this thing has the torque. This thing really has the torque. This thing is very hard to turn at high speeds. This thing can easily get destroyed. Not like that. Hold on a minute. I want to try something. What happens when we take this thing on here? What happens when we take this thing here? And we just go in a straight line and try and yeet ourselves off of the hill. Oh gosh, this is not the smoothest of terrain, is it? Oh, this is not going to be good, is it? We're going to go into a bunch of trees. That went well. Oh wait, coastal road, this is what we need. Okay. Yep, sure. Speed limit's 40. Rookie numbers. We're going 120. Okay, maybe I should actually listen to the speed limit. All right, I'm done messing with the AEV. Let's go and try let's see. I'd like to try the custom. I feel like that would be a good idea. How about the muscle van actually? Hold on. Let's go American here. Whoa, okay. It sounded weird at first because the only thing I was hearing was the turbocharger. Oh my gosh, this thing is not really controllable. And we just caught ourselves into a tree. Okay, maybe we should ease into the throttle a bit. No. Oh, I jumped the curb. Awesome. Come on. Oh my gosh, this thing is not controllable. Okay, never mind. All right, can I? I think the only thing left to do is to try the hill climb because that'll probably be like the most OP car in that in this variant. Oh wait, no, the Jado. That's probably the most OP car. But I'll probably save it for last and like take it off of a giant jump. Oh wow, this thing sounds cool. No, turn! This thing does have good handling, but it doesn't have that good of a handling. Wait, it's still going. Oh! Okay, I think that's done with the, we're done with the American version. Wait, no, that's the wrong button. Hold on. Now we're going to switch maps and go to the Italy map for the European version. See? I'm being a little bit differentiating here. I'm being diverse. That's the right word. Anyways, I'll see you in Italy. All right, we are here in Italy and we have the European version now. And nothing really seems to have changed. Like, I'm surprised that this thing isn't right-hand drive. But one thing that is kind of noticeable is the reverse light, because if I go in reverse, there's only one reverse light. In the American version, there's two. I don't know why that European cars have only one reverse light. That doesn't really seem to make sense to me. But yeah. We are in Italy, and let's try and drive this thing around the tight streets. Which this thing should be able to do. Like, it's made in Europe. It's supposed to be made for Europe, and Europe has fairly tight streets. At least European cities do. Come on, how do you, oh wait, I think this is, the exit! Let's go, so it's a good thing that we can go through the signs. Now let's, go down here. I think this is the way out of town, at least. Oh yeah, this is definitely the way out of town. Yeah, there we go. We are now out of town. Almost. Yeah, there we go. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, we can't really do a whole lot here because, like, of these tight turns. But here we go. See, that's better. Now we can actually open this thing up. Hopefully. Yeah, there we go. Hold on, let's go off of this jump. Let's yeet this thing off the cliff. That was the lamest yeet I've ever seen. I never thought I would actually say that sentence. Oh wait, here we go, here we go. Now we can yeet it. Yep, there we go. Oh, we're going to yeet it into some trees. Oh, that was terrible. Yeah, the doors do work though. Hold on a minute. I must check. One of them works. Oh, wait, it doesn't work that well. Okay. Hold on, reset. Okay, so that was the default variant. It was, I think it might have been all-wheel drive. No, 2.5 TDLX. Okay. And there's actually some police variants. There's a Polizei, which is German police, a medical transport. I think that's Italy, and I don't know what this is for. Oh, Finland, okay. And then there's like a work van, like Beamcom, okay. You got some fleet. Wait, friend. Okay. Wait, turning into a. Where is he getting time machine from? What? Okay, it's got another custom off-road version. It's got another off-road racer. It's got an amateur rally edition, car killer custom, and then of course it's got a JDM car. Okay, we're gonna try one of these. We're gonna try this thing because I'm pretty sure this means ambulance in Italian. At least that's what I think it stands for. Where is it? Like, which one of these has a stop sign? That's what I'm interested in. Like, is there like a minibus for one of these? Oh, yes, here we go. Hold on, we're going to an emergency. Out of the way. I have no idea where I'm going. Yeah, I just wanted to see this thing because this thing actually looks cool. Oh, and we ran into a tree. Okay. All right, so that was the ambulance in this. Something tells me there's a minibus. One of these variants is a minibus, which is why there is a stop sign for one of them. Oh wait, Gendarmerie, that's a another police variant. Let's do the car killer custom. Actually, no, we'll do the amateur rally first. Because we still need to try a rally car here. Hold on, we're going to take this thing to a rally, like a dirt track. Let's find one here. I passed one on my way down the first time. I know that. Where is it? There it is. Okay, here we go. Hey, we spawned in a perfect place. All right, let's test out this thing. Let's see how good this thing really is at rallying. Whoa. Okay, we just flipped. Oh yeah, for some reason this one has ESC and track electronic stability control and traction control as an option on the actions bar on the actions thing. But for some reason it's always turned off. Something tells me that something is wrong with it, either that or it's just broken. Ooh, we just hit the tree there. But we're fine, we're fine. We're still going. Oh, we have some alternate routes here. Okay, we'll go this way because why not? Yeah, just go around the cliff. Whoa, okay. No, I'm falling off. Okay, that's the end of our rally run. Yep, there we go. That's the end of it. All right. Next vehicle. All right, let's see what else do we have. Car Killer Custom, let's try that. Let's see Ellie Custom. Hold on. Wait a minute. Hold on a minute. This thing is from the UK. Does this thing have right-hand drive? This thing caught my interest after reading the description. Oh yeah, it does. Hold on. How does this look? Hey, it does. Okay. And apparently this thing's been severely upgraded. Oh, really? We're going for that? All right. I see how you work, game. Oh, I almost hit that. Okay. Oh, I think we're going back up to the town. If only we had a drift version, this would be perfect. Yeah, this thing does not want to drift, mainly because it has all-wheel drive, though. Hold on. Yeah, that's not gonna work for a turn. Oh, that wheel went flying. Yeah, it's dead. All right, so let's move on to another variant. How about this one? The Car Killer Custom, finally. The moment you've all been waiting for. What is this one for? I probably should have read the description. Oh, for a second I thought it was like an EV, but no, apparently it's not. Oh, but it sounds nice. I feel like this is like a sleeper. Oh yeah, it's definitely a sleeper. Oh yeah, this thing's got some speed. Oh, that's a wool! That's another wool! Hey, it's still going! Never mind, it's going off a cliff. And it's still going. Oh, okay. It's still. Oh, never mind. Drive shaft just broke. Yeah, it's probably done after that. Hold on, is it still gonna go? Nope, it stopped. Okay. Okay, so that's the Car Killer Custom. Hold on, I actually want to read the description on that thing. What is this? Okay, so yeah, it's basically a sleeper, all right. Oh wait, this is a beach car? Okay, a beach van. Let's see what this is about. It's got like the wheels from like one of the ESBR variants, and it's also got a surfboard, which looks really cool. Okay, yeah, I could dig this. Whoa. Oh. Wait, what is that? Wait, what does that say? Vain dream. I don't know. Oh, okay. That's completely right. All right, there's one more version. And of course, we're going into Japan. It's the JDM, probably the best for last, right? All right. So I'll see you. Hold on. In Japan. Okay, so we are actually here in Japan, and there's actually some nice music going around. Okay, I actually had to download this map for this specific reason. So yeah, this looks really cool. This looks really nice. What is with the background? That looks a little bit strange. Okay, I'm not gonna worry about though. But yeah, here we are. We are at a racetrack actually. And this is the base model of the JDM car. It obviously is right-hand drive, and it's got some cool-looking tail lights. Let's actually drive this thing around the commercial area, not through the racetrack. Oh, that's where the music's coming from. Okay, that's kind of cool. It's got a little band. Oh, okay, camera, you're gonna be like this? All right. All right, the raceway. Ooh, okay, we got an intersection here. Let's go this way. Sure, why not? Oh, we got a tunnel. Here we go. Let's see how this does. Oh, here we go. Yeah, now we got that echo. This thing's actually getting up to a decent speed. Oh yeah, by the way, that's a dog in the background. That's my dog. If you're wondering. If you can hear it, that is. I don't know if you can. All right, come on, come on, come on. Oh wow, this thing actually handles quite well, especially for a van. Oh yeah. Look at that. Oh well, okay. Looks like that. Oh wow. Wait. Okay. Okay, that just happened. That was like the most anticlimactic crash ever. Okay, let's actually try out something else. Let's try out a different variant of this. There's actually a lot of actual stuff here. Oh wait, there's a Japanese police variant. That's actually kind of cool. Yeah, there's a lot of custom versions I've noticed. Like you have this one, you have this one, you have, where is it? This one, you have this one, you have this one, and then you also have this one. We're gonna try the road maintenance one because this one looks interesting. I'm pretty sure this is the one that has the stop sign too. Oh, yep, it does. Hold on, let's see what this looks like. B. 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 Wait, sign text. Wait, then which one has the stop sign? I'm actually curious now. Let's see, sign text. Is it K? Yeah, it's K. K. Is this apply? Something tells me that this is broken. This is like severely broken. B, K, what the heck? Hold on a minute, let me get this thing to work. I'll be right back. Okay, for some reason, this thing does not want to do the sign text, but it does have a cool light bar. I will give it that. Oh! I think I'm stupid. I think you need the light. The lights need to be on in order for it to work. Okay, that actually makes sense. I was wondering, wait, why isn't this working? Okay, but yeah, this thing actually has some speed behind it too. I'm impressed. The road maintenance car is going highway speeds. Maybe I can go even faster than that. Hold on. Oh wait, no, it isn't. Hold on. A curb's coming up. Yeah, this is the drifting area. This is like the primary. Pretty sure there's going to be a drift version of one of these things. Oh, yep, there goes the light bar. Yep, that's nice. All right, next variant. All right, JDM. It's got a news van. Let's try this. What's this? Is this like a stance? Okay, so it's just like a regular car, but except it just has like some fancy, a fancy body kit on it. All right, I see. Yeah, it does. Like, there's something different in the back, but I think that's just like an aesthetic. Let's see. What's the next custom one? I think it's this one. I feel like this is I feel like this is going to be good for a racetrack. A racing Kashira, you're probably not going to see this every day. All right, I think you're going through here. Yeah, you do. Okay. Oh yeah, this thing feels nice. Oh wow, those curbs are deadly. Okay. All right, hold on. Let's try this again. Take two on the racetrack. I just want to race this thing just to see how it feels. All right, let's see how else does this go. All right, we're going to slow down here. I thought that was like going to be a straightaway, but apparently not. There we go. I feel like there's supposed to be advertisements there. For some reason they're not showing up. Yeah, this is nice. Here we go. Yeah, this is really nice. I like the feel to it. Oh, this next section of the track looks fairly interesting. Oh, I can actually go over those curbs unlike the other ones. Oh, that was beautiful. I like the transition of that. And here we go across the line. Boom, across the line. And now time for a crash. Oh, that was a terrible crash. Okay. All right, so let's go on to another variant. I want to try out a drift one before I run out of time here. Let's see. What is this one? You cannot tell me that one of these is not a drift car. Oh, tell me this is a drift car. Hold on. This one has to be a drift one. It sounds like a drift one. It sounds like a drift version. Oh yeah, it's a drift version. Okay, hold on, let me find that mountain pass. Because this is gonna be awesome. Hold on, is this it? Oh yeah, it definitely is. This is the famous mountain pass that with all those drift courses. With all those drifting spots. Wait, no, that is. All the way over there. Yeah, I don't know what that is, by the way. I've never been on this map. Let's see. Oh, heck yeah, this is where the fun begins. All right, come on. Oh, what was that? This thing wants to drift. I know it wants to drift. Come on, slide. Why do you want to slide? There you go. Okay, you slide, but then you just spin out. Okay. Is this like a racing ver- is this like just a racing version? That's disappointing. Disappointing at the fact that the one the car you would the variant of the car you would expect to have a drift version doesn't. Okay, we're using the drift version from the American one. I know this one has a drift version. Yeah, by the way, sorry about the long video. I just wanted to do this. Here we go. Now this is a drift version. Oh yeah, this is really a drift version. Hold on. I've never really drifted, so please bear with me here. I just do donuts, okay. Is this like a rotary? Does this thing have a rotary or something? That's what it sounds like. Yeah, I cannot drift for the life of me. This thing... I am not able to drift at all. Yeah, no, I'm not able to. I am really disappointing anyone, any drift community who is watching this right now. They're probably yelling at the screen and telling me what I'm doing wrong right now. Yeah, this sucks. This really does suck. I'm sorry for those of you who have, I have probably ruined that. Okay, that's going to do it for today's video. Till next time, I'll see you next time. Yeah, that makes sense.